For telling data stories, people tend to prefer to use graphics, while tables are also a great option, especially to compare individual values. That's why today I want to show you how to create beautiful tables using the R programming language. So we will begin by using R to connect ourselves to the Spotify API to get the 10 top most listened song of today. Then we will create a table that we will customize. We will add also some images, the pictures of the artist. And finally, I will show you how you can also insert graphics inside your tables to get the best of the two worlds, the tables and the graphics, as a single visualization. And to get the full code of this tutorial, you can join my newsletter on felixanalytics.com. And once you subscribe, you will receive an automatic email from me with the URL of my GitHub account where you can download all the code. That being said, let's get started. So the first thing we want to do is to install and load the necessary R packages if they are not installed on your computer. So you can do that just by running these lines. And then we will load the R package Spotifyer, which is a wrapper for Spotify Web API. The GTR package that we will use today to create these beautiful HTML tables, the library GT extras, which allows to extend this GT package for more customization. We will use once again the tidyverse R package, which is a set of R packages for data wrangling and data visualization, and the scale R package to use scale functions. The first thing we want to do now is to connect ourselves to the Spotify API. So first you need to create an account and get the credentials. And so once you created your account, you can go to this URL, dashboard applications. And here you can create a new app where you can get a client ID and also a client secret. So all you have to do is to copy the client ID and the client secret and paste it inside this code over here. So you can create two global environment variables, the Spotify client ID and the Spotify client secret over here. And these two global environment variables are by default taken by the Spotify R package. And then once you run the get Spotify access token function from the Spotify R package, you will be connected to your Spotify API. So we can run this code. And now what we will do is to download a specific playlist. So I found a playlist that is made by Spotify called Top 50 Global. So that's the playlist we will take the data off using our Spotify API. But if you want to play with another playlist, with your own playlist or a playlist from Spotify for a specific country, all you have to do is to look at the Spotify URL and copy past the end, the playlist ID that is over here. And then you can paste it here in this function. And by calling the get playlist function from the Spotify R package, you will get all the data of this specific playlist. So if we run this, for example, you will see here we have our playlist. So what you can do then is to run the tidy function to make it in a tidy way. We will take the top 10. We will add a new column that is called rank. And I also add a point after each numerical number, so it's nicer in our table. So if I run all this code over here, we will have our first data set that we wanted to have. Now also to have some numeric values, I want to get the audio metrics so you can have specific metrics about each song. So you can see the talent, so how much positivity there is, how much danceable the music is, you have plenty of them. On using this function, we will get the metrics for each of the 10 songs we have here by ID. I will also take some information about the artist from our top global dataset. And to get some pictures or some images we will put inside our table, I will also use the getArtist function, also from the Spotify, to get the URL of the images. So I create this good function over here that we will load. And then we can loop over each artist ID using this function to get the first image for each artist. And finally, here I will join all our different tables by ID and by artist name. And here is our final data set that we will use to create our table. So we have a data frame or table of our 10 top most listened song of today.
according to this playlist run by Spotify. And we have 40 different variables about different metrics about these different tracks. Now that we have our data, we can just create a first table just by running the GT function on specific variables. So here I selected the rank, the track name, the artist name. So this is the first artist. Sometimes in some songs they have multiple artists, but here I just took the first one. The danceability, the valence, and the energy. The valence is the positivity of a specific song. So when there is a high valence, the song is positive, and with a low valence, the song is more negative. Let's just call this GT function to have a very basic, simple table. So here is the result of our table. So now we want to customize it to make it look a bit better. And the GTR package have a lot of functions to allow us to do that for the different elements of the table. So first we can use the calls underscore label function over here to rename the different column names over here. So we will rename the track name as song, artist first as artist, and the rank we will not give it a name, so we will keep it empty. So let's try this. That's a bit better. Now using the tab underscore style, we can style the different elements. So here, for example, for the track name column, I decided to put all the cells as italic using this code over here. So we can give it a try and just walk, right? You can just change the style. You can put colors, bold as you want for each columns. Now using the tab underscore options, we can work on the title that I will add later. So here I just decided to make a bigger title than the one that is by default. And this function allows to add a header tab, so with a title and a subtitle. So let's run this. And here you can see our header on our subtitle with a bigger than the one that is by default. Here I put 24 pixels. You can also add source note here. And if you want, you can add a MD function, which stands for Markdown. So you can use Markdown elements to customize the content. So here with one asterisk, it will be in italic. But if you add two asterisks, for example, it will be in bold. So you can just search online to see how to use Markdown. It's very easy. So let's run this just to have a look. And as you can see here, we have author on felixanalytics.com. And finally, you can add a theme. So here, for example, I took the PFF theme just to change the overall theme. So let's have a look. So here you see it's changed quite a lot, and maybe it looks better. You can just experiment to try other ones. So for example, here we have the 538, Excel, the Guardian, Look Times, and the one I just used. Now I want to show you how to insert images inside your tables. So in our top songs dataset that we just used, we will add the image variable, and we will add this specific function, the GT underscore image underscore cycle function. And you can just add the image. So here is the URL of each images. And if your images are too big, you can specify the height, for example. I also here added the columns underscore whites just to control how large the columns are, as now I'm adding the images. And for the rest, it's the same. And as you can see here, we have our images, so the photos of each artist. So now I want to show you how to customize your numeric variables inside your tables. One idea would be to add a color in your numeric variables so your audience, your reader, can better see which number are high and which number are low. And you can add a color palette to do just that. So we will do it using the skills R package, which contain a hue pale function over here. So I just took these colors over here, and I added the GT underscore color underscore rows function over here for each of our three numeric variables for each color palette. If we run all this code now, we will see that we have a color gradient for each column, so your reader can see more easily which number are high, for example here in strong, in dark red, and lower. So I put that in white, but you can choose the colors, and you can choose the palette that you want. So that's an idea. The other idea would be to add percent bars. So here we are between 1 and 0. So we can more easily visualize using a bar which number are higher and which number are lower. So once again, we will reuse our same color palette, but using this time the GT PLT bar percentage PCT function from the GT extra R package. You see how easy it is. You just add a new function and you will get a new graphic as you will see it now. So here we added bars, but the GT extras package contains a lot of different functions. So you can see the percent dot, the point, the percent till, spark lines. And finally, I want to show you how you can easily merge two columns together. Here we will merge the song on the artist variable. To do that, you just call the GT merge stack function with colon one for the first column you want to merge, here track name, and the second column is artist first. And we can just run the same code as we just did. And as you can see now, we have only one column called song with the song on just below the name of the artist. And once again, if we want to customize it, you can change it to, for example, here dark. It looks different. How does it look very good here? Let me show you another one. So these packages are very amazing. I think it's so easy to customize and create beautiful tables using R. So I hope you found this tutorial useful. If you did, feel free to give me a like or even consider subscribing to my YouTube channel. And once again, if you want to get the full code of this tutorial, you can join my newsletter on felixanalytics.com. And I see you in another video. Take care. Bye bye.